Okay, so the codes signals and systems, codes code CT203. The cadet structure is 3101, imply 3 lectures and 1 tutorial. There is no practical lab session and cadet is 4. Okay. So today, first of all, I'll give you the brief introduction about the course. Then, if time permits, we'll go for details. We'll start today itself. So I'm audible, no?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So sometimes you'll reply, otherwise I'll be confused. Fine. So this course, signals and system, is too useful. In future, you'll be having several other course where the knowledge of the signals and systems will be required. Okay. Just, okay, I'll share the power. Just the paint screen I'll share, because there only I can write it properly. Okay. So this signals and system course CT203, if you go through this course, then in future you can understand better for several other courses like communication system, okay. I think you'll be having two courses for communication systems, analog communication, digital communication. And in future, you may take wireless communication. Everywhere, signal systems concept will be useful. Okay. Second course, you may consider control system. So that is another course. Generally, I am teaching this course. And this is one elective course you may take in future. And there's the concept of signal systems will be required. Okay. I'll be discussing few of these systems later. And third, image processing. Fourth, you may consider speech processing. Okay, there are several subjects, and I am also teaching one course for M.Tech, but again, it is open for B.Tech. That is adaptive signal processing. And one advanced topic of this signal system is digital signal processing. Okay, so many. So there are several subjects where you need the concept of signals and system. Otherwise, you will struggle to understand. Okay, so this is a core course. That's how this is a core course. It's an important course. You should understand every concept of signals and system. And I'll try my best to make you understand everything. And if you have any confusion anytime, please ask the question. Okay. So first I'll give you the course, the syllabus of this course. Then we'll start our discussion on this signal sense system. Okay. No. So this screen is PDF screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
My screen is visible. Okay. Yeah. So before discussing the objective of this course, I told you that there are other several subjects that depends on this course. So here, my main objective is to understand the concept of signals and systems and the interplay or interconnection between signals and systems. Okay. And so those things will be discussed in detail here. Mostly we will focus on to understand the characteristics of signals, the information contained in the signals, like frequency, autocorrelation, all those things. And to understand about the systems, the linear time invariant system, mostly we will focus on that thing. That will be discussed in detail. Okay. But this course is a little bit mathematical. So please enjoy the mathematics. I'll start from very beginning. I don't expect that you know some advanced mathematics topics. That is not required. I'll start from very beginning. Okay. So please attend my lectures. And I hope you'll understand everything. In the suggested books, so these are three books that you can follow. First one is Oppenheim and Wilsky and Nawab, The Signals and System. This is a very nice book. And second book, BP Lati, Linear Systems and Signals. And third one, you can go for Simon Hacking book, The Signals and Systems. I think last one is Pearson edition. Anyway, but I don't follow any standard book. So from my knowledge, previous experience, I'll be teaching you this course. So I may not follow exactly one book as a test book. But you may go through these few books that will help you to understand. Okay. But my expectation is that if you attend all the lectures, you will be able to understand all the things. Okay. And the evolution procedure could be different from this one, what it has been sent. That we'll discuss in detail. So the tutorial. Here we have made 10%, but we can make it 25%. Okay. And the mid-sem, instead of 40%, it could be made 30%. And the end-sem will be 45%. Is it okay? So I'll give you the details later on, but this is right now we are considering the mid-sem will be for 30%, end-sem 45%, and tutorial will be for 25%. Okay. So you see, these are few the course outline of this course. So first we will discuss about the signals. This one. all the things will be discussed, not only these few only: continuous signal, discrete signal, periodic, aperiodic, even an odd signal, signal energy, power, and some classifications of the other things, some operations on signals. Those will be also discussed, and we'll be discussing the basic signals. Those are commonly used in communication or other purpose control systems. Those are unit, step signal, ramp signal, sinusoidals, exponentials. Okay, so those will be discussed in detail. Then we'll go for the systems. Mostly we'll discuss the linearity, the time invariance, causality, memory, and stability. Okay, and we hope we can complete this thing by 3 lectures. Then we'll discuss in detail the linear time invariant system, its impulse response, and the convolution process. I'll discuss it. Okay, this is the outline only. Then the Fourier series representation of periodic signals and Parseval's theorem. Next, we'll consider Fourier's transform. That is a big topic. So this is most important topic, the Fourier transform. And if you understand this one, then communication systems will be very simple to understand. Okay. Then we'll discuss sampling theorem, which is useful to convert a analog signal to discrete time signal. Okay. Then we'll be considering discrete time Fourier transform, DTFT. And then frequency sampling, circular convolution, and DFT, discrete Fourier transform. Then these two, I think you may have certain knowledge about Laplace transform. Then we'll consider Z transform. And next, some filters: low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass filter, band reject filter, all pass filter. All those things will be discussed in detail in both analog and digital domain. Okay. And next one, if time permits, So next one will be random signals that we'll try to include in this course. And the properties of random signal, like autocorrelation coefficient, power spectral density, those will also will try to include in this course, because these are useful for communication system and other things. Okay, this is all about the course, signals and systems. So do you have any question, please? Anybody? No question? Am I audible?
Sir, so, excuse me, sir.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah.
Sir, I wanted to ask. Okay, sir.
Yeah, you're audible. Go ahead.
Yeah. So, sir, I wanted to ask you about the recording. So,
I told you that I am going for recording. Okay. I'll try to record my lectures. Okay. But please don't expect that I'll be sharing the records to you in time, because sometimes I may not be able to record. Okay. So don't rely on those things. Please try to attend. But I'll try to supply you.
Yes, sir.
Recording.
Okay, sure. Okay? Thank you, sir.
But my advice is try to attend my lecture, all the lectures, and it is fine for that. Okay. And this is a large course.
Okay.
Okay. Lots of students are there. I may not go for attendance. And especially I do not give any marks for attendance. That is true. Okay. But I don't expect that you will skip my lectures. Right? I expect all of you will attend my lectures and enjoy these things. And if you have any question, please ask. I'll try to answer, try to give you the answers. I'll try to explain again. Okay? So please attend all my lectures. Yeah.
So do we have to revise do we have to revise for electronics part which was taught in semester 1?
Electronics is not required here. Some concept of circuits like RC circuit, if you can revise it will be good. Okay, R and C circuit. I think you have gone through that one. No? Capacitor and resistor circuit or capacitor. RL circuit, resistive, capacitor and inductor. So those are some example of systems that I'll be discussing. But this is a different topics. So signal systems is different from others like basic electronics, all those things. So concept of basic electronics is not required here in general, okay? Some mathematical part like Laplace transform, if you have gone through, because here also we'll be discussing Laplace transform. Okay. So that could be, I think, this common. So it was discussed, Laplace transform, in the course. Anybody?
No.
No, sir.
The Laplace transform was discussed in the basic electronics course?
No, sir.
In mathematical course, in any mathematics course? Laplace transform is not discussed?
No, sir.
No? Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So if it is not discussed, it is fine. I'll be discussing, okay, those things. Laplace transform, then Z transform, and then filters, all those things, okay? So these are the outlines. So don't worry, I'll be with you and I'll be discussing in a simple manner. I hope all of you will understand. So I don't expect any prior knowledge for this course. Some sort of mathematics, knowledge on mathematics, simple integration, differentiation, and some mathematical operations, simple mathematical operations, if you have. Those are sufficient, okay, to understand this course. Fine. So I'll start this course today only, okay? So let me share my screen again. Okay, so my screen is visible, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so see. So this course, I told you, it is about signals and systems. Okay, so mainly, these are two terms. One is signals, another one is systems. So we need to introduce these two terms in detail, signals and systems. But in this course, we'll study both signals and systems, as well as the interconnection between the signals and systems. They are not isolated. Okay, sometimes signals, okay, we can consider the signals only, we can study the signals only, but system, whenever you consider a system, then there should be some signal. A isolated system There's no meaning. Okay. Now, what is signal? So this signal, basically, it represents physical phenomena. Okay. So any physical phenomena, if anything is there, that you can represent by a signal, and it should contain information. So signal should carry some information, no? And generally, we express, denote these signals by some time varying or, so it can have some independent variables. So it depends on independent variables. So just let me give you some example for the system, then it will be clear. First of all, I should consider that the small letters like X, that will be used to represent a signal. And if it depends on time, that will write here a function of time. So xt, if I say x of t, small x of t, is a signal, and it is depending on time. It is varying with respect to time. Okay. Suppose if I say one particular thing, small v, all small letters are used to represent a signal. Remember, okay, we don't use capital letters in general. So small letters will be used to denote the signals in some domain. Okay, that domain, here it is a time domain. And V, suppose it is velocity of a car, that could be again function of time. Okay, suppose if I consider some temperature, okay, temperature or some other parameters. Okay, so that I can consider capital T or small t better. Or temperature, I can write temperature with respect to days. Okay, so in that case, I'll consider small n. Small n is the integers, days. Suppose in a month, 1 to 30, those days are there. So if I want to understand what is the maximum temperature in every day? So that also a signal. It will contain some information about the temperature, maximum temperature of every day. Okay. So this I am saying that suppose if I consider one speed of a car, it's a function of time. So if I say this is the VT, the velocity of a car, and its velocity is like this, this graph will contain some information. What the information here? So you can see that velocity is increasing for certain time, and it will reach the peak value, the maximum value. Then again, it is decreasing. Then it is almost flat. It's a constant velocity. These are the informations regarding the velocity. So this is one signal. Okay. And for this temperature.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, if the graph is
Any question?
constant.
Listen, please.
Hello?
The graph is?
If graph is constant,
yeah,
then
yeah,
it will not be a signal.
Just right.
If graph is not, if
generally,
graph is constant.
That is the exception. 1 minute. Okay, I got your point. Suppose if this is a signal, okay, what time this is not varying at all, but again, still I can consider it is a x of t. It's a constant, so constant value is, suppose this is a capital A, so this magnitude is a. Okay, and this type of, this is also called as a signal, but it is a DC signal. So this DC signal, it's also one information, but it's a boarding signal, I can say. It does not contain too many informations. Okay.
Sir, but
it
this
contain
graph
only
does not
one amplitude information. Yeah.
Sir, but this graph does not contain any information. Then how it can be signal?
Some information is there, no? The amplitude. What is the amplitude? That amplitude should be known to you.
The amplitude is constant
okay.
all the time. So
it's a constant all the time. Yeah. So that's why I'm saying that it is an exception. So again, if it is constant, then also we'll call it a signal, but this is only exception. But generally, independent variables. But this is signal is exception, then also that also will be considering as a signal. Okay. But it is called a constant signal. But this amplitude is only the information, nothing else. No other thing. It is constant for all time. So why you're considering about the information? If we have also this constant signal, that we can generate easily. No? We can have one voltage source, constant voltage or DC voltage source. That we can generate it. So that is not a big deal. But each signal contains some information that is not known to you. Like suppose you want a speech signal. That signal you want to transmit through a transmitter. It will go through a channel. And at the receiving end, you receive it. You don't know what speech signal it was sent. Then it is a challenge. No, it will carry lots of information and will receive some signal at a far distance. That is more useful. But DC signals are not that much useful. So generally, DC signals are used to test some systems to understand the response of a systems. For that purpose, we'll be using DC signals. Like, I think you have gone through RLC systems or RC system. There we can apply DC signal and we can study response of the system. Okay? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Am I clear? So DC signal is an exception. But other than this one this signal, every signal will vary what time and it will carry certain information. Okay. And you are right that this is because it is everything is known except this amplitude. Okay. Anyway, so we'll go ahead. So we are talking about the temperature of days. Suppose it's the first day, the second day. The third day up to 38 days, suppose. And same temperature. The y axis is the temperature. Yeah. This is the days. The temp much in every day. Suppose the first day temperature was, suppose it is 30 degree centigrade. Next day, I'm calling it maximum temperature, okay? And next day, suppose it is 40 degree, then it could be 25 degree, like that. So what I want to imply that this is also a signal, but here function n, this small n is an integer. So this temperature signal is not continuous. Whereas the speed of a car here, it is valid for every t, but this temperature function is not valid for all values of n, but only if it is an integer value, then only we can have certain temperature, otherwise it is not defined. Okay, these type of signals are called discrete signals. Okay, so we'll be discussing detail the analog signal, continuous signal, and discrete signals. Fine, and a lot of other signals will be discussed. And suppose one more example I can give you. So if you use one microphone, okay, you know, if you speak in front of a microphone, then one electrical signal is generated. So here you will get some voltage. Fine. And that signal, suppose if I represent as x of t, so it will vary with respect to time. And one typical shape of this speech signal could be like this. Some variations are there, like this. Okay. So you see, this is speech, then we'll call it speech signal. Okay, so basically it is an electrical signal, voltage or current, whatever anyone you can consider. This is xt with respect to the axis time. Okay, so this is one dimensional signal. So likewise, we can have more like, if you capture an image, so this image is a two-dimensional. So this is the x coordinate, and this is the y coordinate. So x and y plane, we can represent an image. And in digital image, you know that we can have some small elements of this image. Those are called as pixels. Okay. So in this two-dimensional image, suppose if I consider, so in this image, sometimes to consider capital letter, okay, for two-dimensional signal, the image I, and it's a function of x and y. Okay, and in every coordinate, means every pixel, it will have some intensity level. So if it is a black and white image, then either the pixel value will be zero, or its pixel value will be maximum, that is 255, if it's 8 bit, like that. Anyway, so this is the intensity level. ओके इफ इज ग्रे इमेज द इंटेंसिटी लेवल में वेरी फ्रॉम 0 टू 255 सो दोस विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन इमेज प्रोसेसिंग बट हियर जस्ट आई कैन इंट्रोड्यूस दिस थिंग दैट व्हाट इज इमेज इमेज इज ए टू डायमेंशनल सिग्नल इज इट राइट इज इट क्लियर Is it clear?
Yes.
Any question,
sir.
Please?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So, more than two-dimensional is also possible. Three-dimensional signal. If I consider on video, if you want to send a video through a channel, or if you want to record a video, so video will have. So. That capital V I can consider, it can have three functions. One is X, one is Y. Every frame, we can consider few frames. Those frames, this is one image, I can say 2D image. So several images are coming one by one. Then if you collect several such frames, you will get a video. If you play it, it will look like a continuous changes of the images, okay? So this is X and Y, it's the image frame, and it may vary over time. So it is a three-dimensional signal, X, Y, and T. Fine. So those will be discussed later in detail, and we'll consider the properties of the signals.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, which kind of signal music is we are listening to music? Is it a linear or 2D?
Systems, no, linear, nonlinear, those are not important in the in a system. It is required, but in signal, linear signals that is rarely used. That is called a RAM signal. So we will be coming to this point later. But as you are asking. There's one name is called RAM signal. It looks like this. Left side up to T, it is zero. And then it is growing linearly. Okay. And it's denoted by R of T. It is one kind of, like you can say, linear signal, but linear signal is not defined. Okay. So we'll talk about linear system, nonlinear system, all those things. But signal could be a function of time, could be a function of other parameters. So you can specify with respect to in mathematical model as well. Suppose if I say X of T, so this one, this RAM signal, I can define X of T equals to T for T more than equal to zero, and this is equal to zero elsewhere. Is right? So this is the mathematical formulation of a RAM signal. It's a function of time, and X of T is T for T more than zero right side, and is equal to zero left side. Is it? It was your question? Anything else? So you got your answer?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So we'll be discussing some other standard signals, not only RAM signal. There are certain signals like step signal, impulse signal, exponential signals. Those things will be discussed one by one. Okay. So this is just only introduction. What is all about the signals? So I hope you have got the concept of signals. So signal, I have said that it will represent certain physical quantity, and it will should contain some information, and it should depends on some variables. Those are called independent variables. Like It could be a time, it could be in days, that is one integer values. It could be other things, okay? Like spatial, so image is a spatial signals, two coordinates x and y, okay, like that. Now we'll talk about systems. The systems, basically, it consists of some subsystems. It may contain subsystems. Sorry. Okay, the total systems may have some parts, that we'll call it subsystems. And every systems or subsystems, they should accept some input that I'll call input signal. And it will accept the input signal, and then it is processed by the system, and it will produce certain output signal. Okay, so in general, so I can consider one system as a block. This is one system. Okay, so it will accept one input. Suppose I'm calling it the signal x of t that is applied to the system. Then depending on this system, the signal is modified, and at the output side of the system, we'll receive something different signal. Suppose we'll call it y of t. So this is the input side, input signal. This is the output signal. Okay. So I think you have gone through several such systems in your basic electronics course and also DL, digital logic design course. So digital logic design course is what? Hello? So digital logic design course, it is in this semester or previous semesters?
Previous semester.
So it was in previous semester. Yeah, it's done.
Yeah? It was? Can you
repeat please? Yes, it was in last semester, second semester, so it's done now.
Okay, right. So digital electronics there, I think you have gone through several systems, no? Like a half adder, full adder, those are all systems. Multiplexer, encoder, decoder, all are such systems. And there you will find that, so if it's a digital system, some example I can consider, no? So it will accept some bits, digits only, binary bits could be applied, and you will get an output here, again digital. So input is a digital input, and output is also digital output. Is it right? Suppose we may consider two inputs, okay. Those x and y, and I may get one output, again two outputs I can maybe get it, one is sum, one is carry. I know that It is a half, if I consider it is a half adder, then depending on x and y, you will get sum and carry. So there are some relations will be there between input and output. So this is one half adder digital system. Similarly, you can define full adder. Okay, multiplexer, anything. So those are digital systems. And in basic electronics course, if I consider one resistance and one capacitor, okay, this is R and this is C. This also we may consider as this part. Okay. So here some VIT input voltage we can apply, and we can get certain output. So this is the input side, and this is the output side V naught T. Is it right? So one example I can give you. Suppose if I apply a DC signal, step signal there. This is the kind of signal. Okay. So left hand side, this side it was zero. This is the time. This is one. So at t equal to zero, the voltage is applied. A DC voltage is applied. That magnitude is one. And now R and C, suppose it is given. So R is 1K and C is 1 microfarad. That is 1 kilo ohm resistance, and capacitor is 1 microfarad. Then you can get certain output. So do you remember what is the shape of this output? Anybody?
So exponentially decaying.
Exponentially decaying. Why? I am taking output across capacitor, right? So whenever voltage is applied to the RC circuit, initially suppose capacitor voltage was zero, it was relaxed. So that due to this input voltage one, capacitor will be charging, no? So current will be flowing through this circuit. So capacitor will charge up continuously until it is getting the maximum voltage. So in this case, the maximum voltage is, it will attain one again. So this is the one level. It is not decaying, rather it is exponentially increasing. Okay. So this is your V naught T. This is your VIT. Is right. So we are taking output across capacitor, but if we consider IT as a signal, what is the current? Then the I of T signal, obviously it will be a decaying signal, exponentially decaying signal. Initially you will get a huge current. So you see, if we want to plot this small I of t, the current through the circuit over time, then you see initially what is the current? Can you tell me what is the current?
1 by R.
1 by R, exactly. So if input voltage is 1, then it is nothing but 1 upon R. And from that, it will decay. And when capacitor is fully charged, okay, then there will be no current. So current will become almost zero at t equal to infinity. It's a decaying signal, exponentially decaying signal. So we can also define the function in this form. this is nothing but I think it will be 1 upon r and e to the power minus t upon tau, where tau is nothing but r times c. Am I correct?
Okay. Yes.
So tau is called time constant, r and c. So this is exponential decay. So this is one system. It's an analog system. It will accept one analog input, a continuous input, and also it will produce a continuous output. But it's an electrical system. Fine. Similarly, you can have several other systems, mechanical systems as well. Okay. We can have certain other things, like suppose I can give you one more example. If it is an amplifier, no? Suppose it is amplified, gain is so 10. What is the meaning? Meaning is that whatever signal you will apply to this amplifier x of t, the output y t is nothing but 10 times of x t. Is it right? So this amplitude is increased, is amplified. So this is one analog system again, it's an amplifier. I hope you have gone through amplifier like BJT, bipolar junction transistors could be used as an amplifier, a voltage amplifier. Sometimes it could be also used as a current amplifier. Okay. So depending on signals, if input signal is voltage, if we get the higher voltage here, we'll call it as a voltage amplifier. If input is a current and at the end we'll get a higher current, we'll call it current amplifier. Okay. So those are the systems. Again, we may consider another systems like a square function. What are the meaning? If we apply a continuous signal xt, the output yt is nothing but the square of input x squared t. Is right? This is another example of the system, the square. Similarly, you can have a system integrator. This is symbol used. It's an integrator. Okay. So if I apply XT signal here, and at the output, I'll get the integrated version of the XT. So this YT is nothing but integration of X of, I write it other variable tau and d tau. Okay. And it is from 0 to t, suppose. Fine. Now, can you tell me if I apply a DC signal here, step signal here, if it is 1, what is the output? Anyone, please?
A straight line. Depend on time.
Ramp signal.
Right. Absolutely correct. So if it is a constant, this 1, so you see the area, integration is nothing but the area. If I consider after this time t, so this area is increasing linearly. So this yt will be linear. In this case, it is nothing but only t, the ramp signal. So it is t. So if I apply a step signal here, if it is applied to an integrator, we'll get a ramp signal. So this is the relation between input and output for this system integrator. Fine? Correct. Next one.
Sir?
Next question.
Sir, can we design such system which takes input as a constant signal and output a random signal.
That is not useful, first of all. So if it generates, there are certain signals are there. Sure, there. That is called pseudo noise generator. Okay, we can generate the noisy signal, like a random signal. Okay, you can't predict what will be the amplitude of that one. But from any constant signal, we can generate one noisy signal. Okay, pseudo noise. That is not exactly noise, random. There should be certain relation, but that relation you may not understand in a simple manner. Okay, so if it's a pseudo noise, you know, PN sequence, it is something called pseudo noise generator. PN generator. So any voltage will be a constant voltage will be applied. Okay, so here it will be something like that random. Okay, so it will be like this. Okay, it is purely random. It looks like a random, but it's not exactly random because this system will generate the samples in a certain manner. But that manner, that is a complicated thing. So this sequence are not, there's no relation in the, so in a open eye, you can't see any relation between the samples. These are called samples, but obviously there's a relation between the samples, but you can't understand it easily. Then only, then that's why it is called pseudo noise generator, right? So this type of generator is sometimes used in communication signals, communication systems, especially in the CDMA technology, code division multiple access technology. Okay, so system is there. Have you got your answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so is there? But remember that this system will generate these samples by certain principles. And this principle is defined, properly defined. It's not exactly random. So no signal can generate a random signal. But it may look like a random, that's all. But in reality, you may get a random signal, like a noise. Okay, that will be added in your system. Fine. So these are all. Earlier indicated those are the analog signals. Now we may have also some discrete systems, like it's summer, this kind of thing. Okay. So whatever sequence you will apply here, you will get addition of those things, okay? So if I apply one Xn here, remember this n is integer, then I'll get another sequence Yn, and if I define in that way, summation of X of n, it is from n equal to odd, maybe something other than, say, I can consider m, okay, that then m equal to 0 to small n, okay. So generally this is written as within the bracket, the samples, these are called samples. So if it is 1, 2, 4, 5, minus 2, 3 and minus 1, like that. If this input sequence, now can you tell me what is the corresponding output? So I'll put one arrow here to indicate that this sample is occurring at n equal to 0. Okay, that is notation used. These are the sequence, discrete sequence. At n equal to 0, the first sample is 1, next sample is 2.5, next sample is minus 2, then 3, then minus 1, like that. Okay, now what is the corresponding output samples? What is the first sample?
1.
Anybody, please?
1.
Exactly, correct. Next one?
3.5.
0.5.
So addition of next these two. This and this. And next one is?
1.5.
So this two is 3.5. Then again, minus 2 is at 8. So it is 1.5. Okay? Like that. And then 1.5 and 3. It's 4.5. It will continue. So this is summer circuit. Or adder circuit, I can write. Okay. So we can design such adder circuit. So now, I hope you have got certain idea about the systems. So in this course, what you will do? So in this course, we will study about the signals. We'll study the properties of the signals, different types of signals, and how to analyze the signals, the signal analysis using certain transformation like Fourier series, Fourier transform, Laplace transform, gate transform. Those will be used to study the signals. Okay. Once we'll have certain idea about the signals, then we'll try to understand the behavior of the systems. So if signal is applied to a system, what would be the corresponding output? Okay. We'll study in general. We don't go for any specific one. Okay. I think I can give you a few more, then it will be clear to you. Have you gone through feedback system? Is what it was discussed in your analog electronics basic electronics course?
Yes, sir.
Anybody, please? Feedback systems?
Yes, sir.
No? Yes? Okay. So it will be like
yes,
this.
Yes, sir.
So any signal, voltage signal, if it is applied, XT is applied, then it can have one amplifier here. But sometimes this amplifier performance is not good enough, especially the stability, all those things. So what we'll do to increase the stability of the system, we can go for one feedback system. This is called feedback, feedback network. Network. So some part of output signal is fed back here. Then whatever it will get here, that will be compared here. And this different signal is basically applied to the amplifier, and you will get some controlled thing that will call the output signal YT. So this is one, a feedback system. So is this correct? Fine. So this type of feedback system you will get in one course that I'll be discussing in other semesters. Exactly, the control system, one is there. 1 minute. Okay. So in control system, suppose you have one system already, suppose one motor is there, one system is there, that is in control system, it is, I am talking about control system. One application of the single system course. So this that system is generally called plant. Like a motor. What motor will do? Motor will accept certain voltage, and depending on the voltage, it will rotate. It will give you some rotation. Okay. In the fan, you will have some motor. So this is one plant, but the feature given by the system is not proper one. Is not applicable for your purpose. Okay, it's you are not satisfied with this system. So what you will do? You will use certain mechanism. That mechanism is called controller. We'll put some controller to control this system so that we'll get some desired output. What we want from the system. So whatever we are getting from the system, that is not desired always. Okay. To get a desired output, we need one more system that will control this exact system, which is a plant. Okay. And for that, I may need one feedback as well. It's like this. This is the feedback. That is compared here. So this is called reference input RT, and here we'll get a controlled output CT. It is a reference input. And this is a controlled output. Okay. So if you apply this RT signal directly to a system, whatever output you will get here, that is not supposed desirable. We can't use this directly. Okay. So we need some feedback as well as some controller to get our desired signal. Is it acceptable? Have you got the point? Anybody, please? Have you got the concept of control system? Or should I repeat it?
Sir, could you please repeat?
What I am saying that, suppose I have one system, that system can take one input and can produce one output, but that isolated system, we can't apply, can't use it directly. Because it may not be useful for all the purpose. One example I can give you. Suppose you are using one op amp. I think operational amplifier you have gone through, no? Electrical systems. Operational amplifier. And you know that operational amplifier in open loop, it is giving very high voltage gain. Okay. Suppose if I consider one 741 op amp, its typical gain value is 10 to the power 6. Right? So just see what I am discussing here. So if I consider one op amp operational amplifier. If I apply a signal here VIT, I'll get output V0T. That is nothing but A times VIT. For 741 op amp, this A value is typically 10 to the power 6. Okay. Now, if my input signal is like this, this is our maximum voltage is 1 volt. If this is my VIT, can I apply this input voltage to this op amp? First of all, obviously not, because if I apply this voltage, certain when input voltage is 1, that time output voltage will be 10 to power 6 volt. That is huge, and this operational amplifier can't produce that kind of voltage here. It has certain limitation. It has certain power supply voltage, no? VCC is there, and if VCC is 10 volt, so maximum it can produce 10 volt. So it is going to saturation level. So whether it is a 1 volt or 2, 1.5 volt or 0.5 volt, it does not matter. Every time output will be 10 volt. Am I clear? So this open loop op amp is going to give you a constant voltage all time, saturated voltage. That is of no use, because we want one amplifier. I want here some similar characteristics, but okay, amplitude could be little bit larger, no? So here it was 1 volt. Suppose if I expect that it should be around 10 volt maximum, then I am happy. This is desirable, but this is not desirable. Okay. Have you got my point? So in that case, you have to use this feedback mechanism to get a proper signal. So any question, please? So we'll stop it here today. We'll continue in the next class. But if you have any question, you can ask me. Any question, please? So no question. So our next class will be on Friday at 12 o'clock. Please join with us. Don't miss any single class. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.